Hello there, my fellow Xenos-hating exterminators, and welcome to an actual new playlist and series for 40k lore. Haven't started one of those in a while, have I? This new series is going to focus on a topic I've gotten quite a few requests for, and namely the super-duper elite Deathwatch. During the course of this series, we are going to discover together a number of things about them. These will include their watch fortresses and stations, their specialist ranks, their organization, their war gear, recruitment policies, relics, and more. But for today, like I do in most of my series at the beginning, I will tell you a bit about who they are in general and some of their history. I am your usual host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us begin learning about the Deathwatch, shall we? The Deathwatch Space Marines serve the Ordo Xenos of the Imperial Inquisition as its Chamber Militant, which is fancy talk for private army. They are the warriors of last resort when the Inquisition needs access to firepower greater than the Imperial Guard, or a team of its own acolytes, or even the throne agents can provide. Across the galaxy, there are innumerable hostile alien civilizations which threaten mankind. From the green-skinned orcs, to the monstrous Tyranids, sadistic Dark Eldar, spectral Catan, and undying Necrons. It is the sacred task of the Deathwatch to stand sentry against all of these terrible Xenos races. They are perpetually ready to act when such ancient evils rise again to threaten mankind. The Space Marines of the Deathwatch form the first, and often only, line of defense against these inhuman horrors. Unlike other Space Marines, the ones serving in the Deathwatch are not really a separate chapter of the Adeptus Astartes. Rather, they are a collection of veterans, drawn from all the different extant chapters, who served in the Inquisition service for a discrete period of time. To be chosen by one's chapter to serve in the Deathwatch is a great honor for all Space Marines, as only the most elite and experienced members of the chapter are ever chosen for this extremely hazardous tour of duty. The specifics of these duties must also be kept a secret by Inquisitorial Order and Sacred Oath even from a Deathwatch Astartes home chapter. Deathwatch Space Marines do not usually form the standard tactical groups like squads and companies generally used by the Adeptus Astartes. Instead, they operate as small special forces units in close-knit groups of specialists called kill teams. If a Xenos threat is particularly dangerous, several kill teams will be assigned to deal with it. If the threat is still too much for the Deathwatch to handle, the Inquisition will then turn to a full Space Marine chapter or to multiple regiments of the Imperial Guard to deal with it. In general, if a group of Deathwatch kill teams cannot deal with a Xenos incursion, that means the Imperium has a major conflict on its hands, and must deploy the full might of its military to meet the threat. The exact origins of the Deathwatch are uncertain in current Imperial records, but its inception can be traced to 554 of M32, and the arrival of the largest Orc Wa ever seen since the Ulanor Crusade. Led by the mysterious warlord known only as the Beast, this greenskin invasion threatened the very throne world of Terra itself. During the conflict, it was the newly elected Lord Commander of the Imperium, Chapter Master and sole surviving member of the Imperial Fists, named Corland, who came up with the idea. He devised the concept of utilizing small Astartes kill teams to eliminate vital assets of the encroaching greenskins, and eventually the Beast itself. Though reluctant at first to acquiesce to the Lord Commander's plan to approve the creation of such a force, desperate times called for desperate measures. Therefore, the High Lords of Terra consented to Corland's proposal. The original recruits for this newly created elite force were drawn from the survivors of the various chapters that took part in the initial invasion of the Beast's capital world of Ulanor. These chapters suffered severe losses during the invasion. Thus, standing vigil over their fallen brothers, the seeds of the Deathwatch were sown. Lord Commander Quarland eventually came to an agreement with the Inquisitorial representative to assuage any doubts by the rest of the members of the Senatorum Imperialis. This meant that the Deathwatch would fall under the purview of the Inquisition, but an Astartes would ultimately serve in the role of Chapter Master. However, there are conflicting accounts which state the Deathwatch's origins occurred somewhat differently, and that it was founded only centuries and not millennia ago. These records state that a conclave of Inquisitor Lords, the Apocryphon Conclave on Orphite IV, convened with the sole purpose of formulating an Imperium-wide strategy to combat the many Xenos threats that assailed mankind. The numbers of this conclave were, in the main, drawn from the ranks of the Ordo Xenos, all of whom shared the belief that one day there would come a time when humanity would be consumed by slavering Xenos creatures, or enslaved to creatures of alien origin. They foresaw an age when every alien lifeform in the galaxy, and others beyond it, might rise up and the age of the Imperium would come to an end. They had no idea when such a terrible age might come, but they knew with dreadful certainty that it surely would, and they determined that no effort should be spared to avert such an end. The conclave sat for many years, and bitter debate raged back and forth between Inquisitor Lords of many different positions. Some believed that every trace of alien life should be purged from the galaxy. A few advocated the formation of alliances with those alien races that could be tolerated. Some spoke of ancient, godlike beings that have slumbered since before the creation of mankind, awakening to enslave the galaxy, while others foresaw that death would come at the hands of invasion from another galaxy entirely. The conclave would request an audience with the assembled chapter masters of the Adeptus Astartes and ask of them a solemn undertaking. It is not known how many chapter masters assembled to hear the words of the conclave, for such an event has only occurred a handful of times in the long history of the Imperium, nor were the words of the Inquisitors recorded for posterity. Certainly, enough of them must have answered the call, for eventually a quorum was convened. The conclave presented its prophecy to the chapter masters, evoking the galaxy-wide threat of the ravening Xenos. The chapter masters, each and every one of them a veteran of 1,000 campaigns, listened to the Inquisitor's words and withdrew to consider the matter. The results of the chapter masters' deliberations were delivered to the conclave at sunrise the next day. Each of the masters and inquisitors took a solemn oath together. They would form a new chapter, consisting of veteran space marines highly experienced in combating Xenos. The chapter was dubbed the Deathwatch, for it would stand guard against the doom foretold by the conclave. Thus, to this day, this joint oath still stands. The Battle Brothers of the Deathwatch take the war against the alien to the very darkest reaches of the Void, bringing to bear such force as no individual Inquisitor could hope to muster. In this particular objective, the Ordo Xenos and the Deathwatch are equals, the Inquisitors rooting out the foes for the Deathwatch to eradicate. While neither party is subject to the command of the other, both work in concert towards a common goal, according to those oaths made a long time ago. Now, some of you may be a bit confused, as I've just told you two different versions about the origins of the Deathwatch. So I will try to explain why that is. You see, the Deathwatch has been in 40k lore for quite a bit, and up until about 2 years ago, the second story I told you was probably the official version. However, about 2 years ago, the Black Library released a series of novellas called The Beast Arises, which, whether we like it or not, is pretty much canon now. I'm not gonna go into details on it, but suffice to say, it deals with the greatest orc war ever seen, which almost breaks both the Imperium and Terra itself. While the series itself is not bad, in my opinion, they did implement a few lore landmarks which kinda conflict with older established canon. But then again, you can always read for yourself and decide. As the 41st millennium draws to a close, the shield of the Deathwatch has been shaken, shivered, and brought to the edge of destruction. Never before have so many threats to the fabric of mankind's realm risen up at the same time. Never before have so many powerful Xenos races sought to take the galaxy for their own. A thousand horrors gnaw and tear at the fabric of reality. Foes, both old and new, taking their chance as mankind is torn apart by its long war against chaos. The Eldar fight for a resurgence 10 millennia in the making, taking no prisoners as they seek to burn brightly before the end. Their vile cousins, the Dark Eldar, intend to fill their pantries before the apocalypse breaks, raiding in such numbers to leave one's thriving worlds empty of sentient life. The Necron dynasties awake faster than the Deathwatch can put them down. Long-buried armies lurching to life as ancient overlords attempt to restore a lifeless order to the era of mayhem that greets their awakening. The Orcs, a threat long turned upon itself by the Deathwatch's surgical raids, are finally uniting under the Prophet of Armageddon. Their green tsunami of violence is set to drown the stars. On the eastern fringe, the tech savant armies of the Tau Empire expand aggressively, their invention of the ZFR Horizon Accelerator engine pushing them across the Damocles Gulf at a shocking pace. Further out, adrift and numberless, are the bioships of the Great Devourer. Among these, perhaps it is the High Fleet Leviathan that should be feared the most, for its splinter fleets emerge from under the galactic core to menace the Segmentum Solar, the seat of human civilization itself. With every standard year, more requests are leveled onto the wider Adeptus Astartes by the Deathwatch, citing ancient oaths to claim tithe after tithe. Yet the astropathic messages flow both ways. Hundreds of chapters are formally requesting their battle brothers be discharged from their long vigils and sent back, despite the tarnishing of their honor that entails. In this time of woes, every space marine is vital in the war against the dark powers. Whether humanity will survive to see a new age is unknown, but the Deathwatch is fighting with every inch of its power to ensure it. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to say regarding an introduction for the Deathwatch. Is this unofficial chapter and branch of the Inquisition among your favorite factions? Let me know why in the comments below. Was this video entertaining or informative? In that case, please consider clicking the like button and subscribing for future content. And if you'd like to help me keep making these videos, please go check my Patreon page, the link for which is in the video description. I thank you very much for watching, and I wish you all an awesome day. The Emperor protects.